Hi, I'm Bill Villain. Thank you for joining us today. We are going to talk about a brand new magazine for here in Brantford. In Brantford, a magazine, a nice glossy magazine. I've seen it in other towns in our area. The magazine is going to be called Brantford Magazine. And this is a good town to have a nice glossy magazine with good pictures of the shoreline. I love the shoreline here. And my guests are sitting next to me is Roger Dietz, who is the owner and publisher of RDS Media LLC. Thank you, Roger.
Thanks for having us.
And our other guest is the editor in Wallingford of Wallingford Magazine, Taryn Granusi. Taryn, thank you very much for joining us.
Happy to be here.
Brantford Magazine, we're taping this in May, so we'll be showing it once the magazine comes out. But
sure.
Let's talk about the magazine coming up. When is it going to come out? This
we are actually going to print in the next couple days.
Okay.
We are our ads, our revenue's in, our stories are written, our pictures are taken. We've got a cover. We're going to print. We'll be out into May.
Okay, before Memorial Day, right?
Yes.
Good, good. You're excited about... Oh, that's a stupid question. Of course you're excited.
It's a brand new market for us. Mm-hmm. It's our fifth market, and we're very excited about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice to be here in Brantford. We're looking forward to being in Brantford.
Mm-hmm. Have you taken tips from Taryn regarding what he's learned and what you both have learned in Wallingford and bring it to Brantford?
Absolutely, yeah. Taryn's been real instrumental in growing the company. He's been working in the Wallingford market for the last 4 years or so, and has brought a lot to leverage the Brantford magazine as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Your company is what, seven years old now?
We started in 2011.
Okay.
We brought our first magazine out in Southington in 2011, and several years later we started in Wallingford, which has now been, we're on our 17th edition there. And we've on our fourth edition in Cheshire and our fourth edition in North Haven. And we'll now start our first here in Brantford.
We spoke when you started the magazine in North Haven. Your editor in North Haven, Jill Tichello, was
yep.
on with you. What have you learned since you came up with the North Haven magazine, and what are you bringing? What from that are you bringing into Brantford?
You know, North Haven is a small community. It's a tight-knit community, and they take a lot of pride in their town. And one thing I find from launching these various magazines is that every town is that way. These small towns, they take a lot of pride in their town. They're tight-knit. Brantford is the same way. Wallingford loves Wallingford, and they love the magazine because it's a Wallingford magazine. So North Haven's like that, and we're looking forward to that being the same situation here in Brantford.
Mm-hmm. I want to show some covers of your other magazines. If you could bring up that slide, that would be great. This is a glossy magazine, and I know you've said it's a coffee table magazine.
It is.
It sort of looks like a town version of Connecticut Magazine. Would you say that?
Yeah, it is. It's a town magazine. It's a different format, but it's a high end. It's real nice paper, beautiful pictures, well written stories. And, it's supported by the advertisers in town, and even their ads are beautiful. Real nice-looking ads.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just something to browse through. It's very enjoyable.
Can you tell me about the covers? Let's just go through the four towns. Why did you pick these covers? I know living in Cheshire, I know that is the Congregational Church on the green in
Cheshire.
That
is the Congregational Church. That picture was taken at sunrise. And I'm not sure if you can see it quite here, but if you were holding the magazine, you'd see that the church has a very pink tint to it, and that is the rising sun hitting the church. It's a beautiful picture.
Yeah, I can see the pink from here.
Yep.
And, of course, your editor in Cheshire is Ron Gagliardi.
Ron, yeah.
Who also does a TV show in Cheshire.
He does. He has a 30 Minutes with Ron.
30 Minutes with Ron, yes.
Yeah.
A friend of mine has been on his show.
Right, he's a character.
Yes,
I like Ron.
Yes, I've talked to him on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
North Haven, what are we looking at here?
It's a spring shot. It's just the beginning of spring. You know, we've got the blooms happening. That was really our first spring issue of the four that you see there. And everybody was looking to get rid of the snow. And that was a welcome sight right there.
I liked your Christmas one, the one with the Christmas tree on the green. My friend Darlene Wetmore did that picture in North Haven.
Yeah, that was a nice cover.
Right, she's a member of the North Haven Camera Club, and she's excellent with photography. Yep. Southington, this looks like somebody has a hobby of skiing.
We have a ski mountain, Mount Southington.
That's right.
In Southington, and this picture was taken by a professional photographer. We love having the photographers come and submit work for us because they do great work. And that was shot there right off a jump. Beautiful picture. And the person, the kid who that is, saw the picture and immediately knew, that's me. That's me. We hadn't told him ahead of time.
Turner, I'm going to let you talk about Wallingford, but to me that looks as if that was taken during the golden hour in the morning. Am I correct?
Sunrise, the eastern part of town, taken by a woman who is very involved in the town of Wallingford. She is a former town councilor, and this is in her yard looking toward the sunrise early in the morning after a snowfall.
Nice
and
yard.
She just took the shot and posted it on Facebook, and I contacted her and asked for permission to use it, and she was delighted to allow us. She didn't even want credit, but we still gave her credit for the photograph.
Seeing you said the eastern part of town sort of reminds me of how the town looks like on the way to the two wineries there.
Yes, and, up in that area, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And just a little bit about Golden Hour. If you go online to look up Blue Hour for photography or Golden Hour for photography, mm-hmm. you can see why those are good hours to
yes.
take pictures. And,
yeah.
and she
yeah.
took advantage of the Golden
nice
Hour.
Nice lighting, yes. yeah.
Mm-hmm.
yeah.
Same with the church,
exactly.
the lighting on the church.
Yeah.
We are talking about the brand new Brantford magazine here in Brantford. My guests are Roger Dietz, who is the owner publisher of RDS Media LLC, mm-hmm. and Taryn Ganusi, who is the editor of Wallingford magazine. Can you tell us what's going to be in the first issue, or is that a surprise?
Well, it will be a surprise. I think it'll be a delight. We have some interesting stories, some history. We've highlighted a few entrepreneurs in town. What we bring to the people in town is a positive experience. To flip through the pages of our magazine is nice reading. It's upbeat reading. We don't take sides. We're not talking religion. We're not talking politics. But we want to bring you something that's enjoyable to read. There's some depth to it as well. It's not all light. But when you're done reading, when you finish that last page, I want you to have a smile on your face.
It is uplifting, your magazine, your Cheshire mm-hmm. magazine. Of course, I get that in my mailbox.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking about getting the magazine in the mailbox, everybody in Brantford will get a free copy in their mailbox.
100% saturation. That means we deliver to every deliverable address in town. Every resident and every business gets the magazine. So distribution is important. Mm-hmm. We want everybody to have it.
Mm-hmm. Roger, in turn, what kind of a study did you do ahead of time so you know that you could target Brantford for Brantford being its own kind of community, like any other community in Connecticut is?
Yeah, well, Tarn and I came down a couple times and looked at the town. We've looked at other markets as well. We're actually in growth mode, so we have our eyes open for other places to go. But Brantford has, it's very upbeat. It's got a lot of businesses. It's got a beautiful shoreline. It has a town green that's gorgeous. There's a nightlife. The demographics are similar to some of our other towns. So, and then we ran into Bob Dayhill down here, who's going to be the editor of the Brantford magazine. He's entrenched in this town, been here for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a home run.
Mm-hmm. Good. How many times a year?
5 times a year. So we do one each season. And then we do a special holiday-ish edition.
Mm-hmm. I could picture a nice picture of the green for Christmas time.
Yep.
And
yeah.
For
well,
summer,
I'm sure the green will grace the cover at some point.
And summer, fall, and spring, I could picture water.
Mm-hmm.
Or the green.
There's a nice shoreline, the Thimble Islands. There's a lot here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Got to ask you a question. I know that. You know what this looks like, right? You know what this looks like?
Yeah, who doesn't?
It's a cell phone. Everybody goes on here. They're on Facebook. There are ads on Facebook. You can read the Register app, Channel 3 app, whatever. In the days of social media and the internet, how can a print product compete with new media?
Well, Tarn, I've been doing all the talking. What do you have to say about that?
Well, first of all, it arrives as a work of art. As you see from our covers, they're beautiful. I've been told by many adults who run the household that they sit down with the whole family when it comes, with their children and their husband, and they all sit down and read the magazine together. So it's reaching multi-generations. Obviously, the younger generation is a little harder to reach for anything in print, but what we've found is that people don't throw them away. They save them, they collect them, and so often it'll be on the coffee table for months at a time. So it would be hard not to be even a little curious, even if you're on your phone most of the time, to take a look at this magazine. And it's the people love it. They can't wait to get it. The only complaint we ever get is if they didn't get one.
Okay, good. And you make sure that they get one.
Yes.
In the digital world today, and the digital world's wonderful, you know, you have everything you need at your fingertips. But it is also a little overwhelming. It occupies a great amount of your time. And this is something entirely different. It's tactile. You know, it has a good feel to it. It's nice to hold. It's nice to open. It's nice to read. And that is a completely opposite of what's happening in the digital world all day.
Would you call this, you know, of course, Connecticut Magazine, we all know what that is. Mm-hmm. It's a nice glossy magazine. It's
beautiful,
a statewide magazine. Is it like a community version of a Connecticut Magazine type?
Hometown. We're bringing a hometown pride. Mm-hmm. You know, we're dealing with your own town and the people in your town and the nonprofits in your town and new startups in your town and organizations, current events, the history of your town. People love the history of their own town. Mm-hmm. And a town like Brantford, we're talking, you know, 400 years of history. So there's a lot to bring to the people.
So you're into history and you are into current events in a
Both,
town,
yeah,
right?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. The one good thing about a town medium, whether it's Brantford BCTV here in Brantford or mm-hmm. Your magazine, Brantford Magazine, you can focus on the town. If you take, and this is not a dig on anybody else, if you take New Haven Register, Channel 3, Connecticut Magazine, they have to serve a wide
They have a larger
area.
Market.
And so something that's of interest here, somebody sitting in Cheshire is going to go, I'm not interested. Whereas Brantford Magazine, just like BCTV, you can do something that's Brantford-oriented.
Exactly.
And it relates to most of the people who pick up that magazine.
And they take pride in it. It is hometown pride. Mm-hmm. It's their magazine. Mm-hmm. It's about their town. It's their history. It's the businesses in their town. It's the nonprofits in their town. It's what's going on in their town. And it's brought to them in a beautiful medium. Mm-hmm. So it's a working model. It's a successful model.
Right, and you're staying away from politics because there are other newspapers, local papers
that
do
politics.
There are papers who do plenty of politics.
Right.
So you said the word gap, right?
We are filling a gap that you don't get every day. You know, you can get any of that information any time of the day for the politics of what's going on. And I think it's overload. Actually, I think most people think it's overload. So this is something entirely different for you.
Mm-hmm. Interesting that you said the word overload. So you basically looked at your business plan, your editorial plan, and say, let's not do something that's an overload elsewhere.
Let's go a different direction, not the direction everybody else is. Let's find something a little different. And that's what we found. We have found that.
Can you give me an example with a certain kind of story? Let's say either something current or something historic.
Tarn wrote a beautiful article in the last magazine about Trod Nozzle, which was a... Well, why don't you tell a story? It was tremendous.
Trod Nozzle sits in a humble little building in Wallingford. in a off of quiet street down near the railroad tracks. You would never look at it and think anything of it. It was started in the 50s or early 60s by Doc Cavalier, a dentist from Hamden, and it just sort of serendipity brought it into being a recording studio that attracted some of the most famous rock bands in America and the world to record in Wallingford over the years. And it's still in existence today. Doc's daughter, Darlene, and her two brothers run the organization, and they're still recording for major stars from just the country and around the world.
And that's
and
a kind of
story. It's a great story. And most people in Wallingford never heard of it.
Exactly. Really? Didn't even know that it existed really? In their own town.
Well, maybe I know it because of, you know, being in the radio business and TV, and maybe that's why I know it. But the Trod Nozzle's been around forever and ever.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Right. And he had a real strict, he ran that place. Strictly. There was no drugs. If you're on drugs, get out. Mm-hmm. Right. They respected him when they came there. I mean, the Stones were there. Fleetwood Mac was there.
Yep.
The list goes on. I can't think of them offhand, but there was a lot.
Too many to remember.
Right in Wallingford. And we bring that to the people in town, and they read that, and it's like, are you kidding me?
So you would take a business that's been in business forever and ever. I'm thinking of Louis' Lunch in New Haven. Something like a Louis' Lunch in New Haven. If they were here instead of there, you'd probably do their history.
What happens once the magazines come out, once it's in people's hands and once it's in town, the people, stories, photographers, comes out of the woodwork. Mm-hmm. People tell us, you know, we've had this jewelry store, it's been in our family for 125 years, this is a great story, you should write a story about us. And that's the kind of stuff that comes to us, and we want to write those stories, and we want to hear those stories.
Mm-hmm. Today in Wallingford, as I walked around town, I went to various events and businesses, I had 5 people approach me with stories that they would like to have told in the magazine, just being out in public. Everybody loves it so much, and they want their story, not necessarily their private personal story, but a story that they know about that would be a nice addition. So there's, now that we've been established for so long, people just want more and more and more, and they want to be part of it, and they can be part of it.
I
didn't write that article, Joe Pager. In case Joe sees this, Joe Pager wrote the article about Trod
Nozzle. I just say that because you're the editor.
Yes, I edited
it. From my perspective, Tarn wrote it. But yes, I understand Joe wrote the article.
Credit where credit is due.
Branford Magazine, my guests are Roger Dietz, the owner and publisher of RDS Media. Branford Magazine is a new magazine coming out this month in May. We're taping this May 10th. And Tarn Ganusi is the editor of Wallingford Magazine, and you've helped put the Branford Magazine together.
Yes.
And your editor in Branford, his name is?
Bob Dayhill, Robert Dayhill.
What's Robert Dayhill's background, please?
He has been in advertising, so he knows the advertising world. Advertising is very important part of the magazine. It is the revenue that supports the magazine, so it's important to have someone who understands that world. He's a very energetic, personable guy. He's going to do great here. People are going to love him.
Good. Editor and a reporter?
We wear a lot of hats.
You wear a lot of hats.
We all wear a lot of hats, yeah.
It sounds like BCTV.
It's a small business, you know. We fill in where we have to fill in. We do what we have to do. It's very exciting. And the closer you get to deadline, this thing has to get out, and this has to happen, and this has to happen. Everybody pulls together, makes that happen. We have a graphic designer that's really talented. We have people that are writers that are very talented. Everybody pulls together and makes it all.
Well, I'm looking forward to Branford TV. We're Branford TV. Branford Magazine coming out.
Yep.
Roger Dietz, owner and publisher of RDS Media, LLC. And Tarn Granusi, the editor of Wallingford Magazine, a companion magazine. So sometime this month, you will see a copy of Branford Magazine in your mailbox.
Yes, you will.
Gentlemen, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
This has been a pleasure, and I know you're going to go home and watch Yankees Red Sox, and I'm going to go home and watch
that is
Yankees,
what I'm going to do.
Red Sox. I know we're on opposite.
Go Yankees.
Go Red Sox. I want to thank our crew, Owen Bigler, Victor Hoag, Henry Ponda, and our station manager, Walter Mann. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.